lunch at the Silver Diner and a nap at H.H. Gray. And we were talking about something really dumb. He glanced at me at a stoplight and he said, "Hey, Nick, I bought you some new headphones and they're pretty cool." My interest suddenly piqued. I replied with, "Oh, really? What brand?" "Barbie," he said, eyes shining with anticipation. I think about this for a couple seconds, imagining how cool I'd look when I walk into psychology class, and how funny it'll be, so I said, "You know, I'll still wear it, right?" My dad turns to me and looks me square in the face, and he says, "I know you will, and that's what I love about you. You're a weird dude, but you don't care." Thanks, Dad! But he's right, you know. If you present yourself on the outside the way you actually are on the inside, you'll probably meet people that are likely similar to yourself, and you can all have a beautiful, weird relationship. As nice as that sounds, many people in today's society find themselves unable to experience this for themselves, pressured by anxiety and societal demands. They force themselves to squeeze into the mold. It's like trying to put the square peg in the circular hole in that baby puzzle. With so many people going through life wearing these masks,